We have one of the nicest high voltage labs in North America.
We've selected this one because of its capabilities.
Basically, the purpose of the high voltage lab is to make sure that we keep the power on the power lines. And with the cascade transformer, we can produce 1.1 million volts. And we use that to test things like insulators, hot sticks, transformers, capacitors, bushings, to make sure that they can withstand those higher voltages. So we do quality assurance tests, we do safety investigations, we do failure analysis on equipment that's failed. So those are a few things that we do. And then the other type of test that we do is the impulse generator, which is behind a cloth over there. We're protecting it because of the testing that we're doing today. But with that, we can produce lightning here in the building. That models when lightning strikes our transmission lines. We want to make sure that they can withstand that and all the equipment associated with it can withstand the lightning strike. We do tours all the time. In fact, not only BPA employees, but we have students come through here ranging from middle school all the way through college. We've hosted industry groups here. We get a lot of Dr. Frankenstein references. You could think of the high voltage lab as being able to produce really high voltages, but with a small amount of current. So we can produce 1.1 million volts at about 3/4 of an amp. And since this is a special test that we're doing here today, we needed a medium amount of voltage and a medium amount of current, and we needed the big high bay. So we ran a special feeder cable from the medium power lab into the high voltage lab temporarily for this test. EPRI is the Electric Power Research Institute, and it's a utility-funded consortium that does basic research in the power industry. And Bonneville Power is a member of EPRI, meaning that we spend money and in return we get results of their research. And this is a project that we've been contributing to through the Technology Innovation Office, but we're also contributing the actual testing in this case.
The goal of the project is to develop equations, develop guidelines for protection from arc flash, protection of workers, live line workers who may be on a structure during an unintended flashover. There have been several incidents of insulating tools, hot sticks, flashing over. Fortunately, no fatalities or very, very serious incidents. So in that respect, this is a very important issue, both for safety and both and the understanding as to what protective measures or protective clothing should be used.
So when you have a short circuit on the power system, you create an arc, and the arc is basically plasma. It's the same as the surface of the sun. It's super hot and it's a hazard because it can burn you. And so what we're trying to do here is reproduce those conditions. And so we've created a tower. It's got a conductor and an insulator just like any other tower. And we're actually causing that insulator to flash over and producing an arc. And then we measure the temperatures around it to see what the exposure to the worker would be. And what we'll use that for is to determine what sort of protective clothing our workers have to wear to protect them against that. It's a difficult test to do. It's never been done before in this way. And there were a lot of unknowns.
And we are trying to understand the behavior of the arc, locations which are more prone to high incident energy and lower incident energy. We had some expectations that the exposure levels would be lower than predicted by equations. So no really significant surprises. We're just learning details of the behavior of the arc in situations where tests have not been performed in the past.
The arcs that we're producing here today are not likely to burn someone. But what they can do is validate the models that are used to calculate the exposure of the workers at higher arc currents. Unfortunately, to actually reproduce the burning conditions, we would have to cause a system disturbance, and our customers don't like that for some reason.
basically what we're trying to do is get a image of a guy up on the bridge.
I guess we could do that.
We have a very good working relationship with Vancouver, with this laboratory, and this is an opportunity to do real research. That's a very, very good atmosphere, working atmosphere, and scientifically very encouraging.
There were a lot of unknowns, and the results seem to validate the assumptions in the models that we've seen so far. With this project, BPA is using the BPA laboratories to establish a leadership position and to offer to the industry expertise that nobody else can offer. And through that, we're going to make our linemen and linemen all over the country and possibly the world safer as a result.